Well, first of all, our decision to resign should be lauded because it took a lot of courage for her to, regardless of whether there was pressure on her from the presidency or from any quarter, to for her to resign, for her to take that decision to resign, she ought to be commended. But to the fact that the offense itself, the criminal aspect of it, that forgery would not be looked away, you understand? Because even in her letter of resignation, she referenced that indirectly, she admitted to the fact that it was a forged certificate, saying that some people that probably she engaged to go and get the documents, she trusted them, and unknown to her, it was a forged document. So the fact that she has used it to get employment under with Ogun State government and at the federal level. So the issue is that we must separate the criminal offense from the moral offense. The moral offense is the fact that she has been using it to get employment. But the criminal offense is that it's a forgery. And forgery is forgery, regardless of whatever it is. Our criminal code is clear. If you forge a document, there are punishment that is attached to it. So asking for our prosecution, it's not beyond what the law requires. The fact that she even resigned is a double confirmation that certificate is a forged document.
Well, I think it's a good thing that she resigned. I think it's really a step in the right direction. But then again, where there is a law, you have to follow the law. So it's not a question of morality. Okay, she did the right thing, so let's just be kind. The law doesn't, recognize that. So we need to do what the law says. We need to prosecute when someone has committed an offense. It's a different thing when she gets to court. If the court clears her, that's okay. But we need to take that step as well.
For me, I think she did the right thing by resigning. I do not support the fact that she should be prosecuted because I feel the punishment, the resignation is enough stigma in itself. So I feel she should be left to go freely. That already affects her status, and to be able to vie for any other position or to qualify for any other appointment, that already affects her. So I don't think she should be prosecuted.
I don't agree she should be prosecuted. Because she's a victim of set-up fraud, although she was being negligent by not at least confirming the authenticity of that exemption certificate. And moreover, there's no evidence that she conspired to forge the exemption certificate. So I don't believe she's prosecuted. Instead, it was search for those people that processed that exemption certificate and deceived her and presented that certificate to her as genuine.
Well, I'm calling for prosecution because resignation is not enough. If actually it belongs to a party of integrity, change, as they say, should start with them. I remember the case of Salisu Buhari, a Toronto saga, was prosecuted and was made to face the music, not until the president then, that was Obasanjo, granted him presidential pardon. And at this particular point in time, I will advise Adeosun to face the music right now when principal or boss is still on throne. Because if he escape trial now, he may likely face the music in the nearest future, and it will be detrimental. He may not be granted presidential or pardon then. But it is better for her to face it now and probably be given the opportunity of presidential pardon than to escape it now and face it in the nearest future, which may be detrimental to her career.